nth term of harmonic progression. So here we know the genform of arithmetic progression as A, which is the first term, and the nth term as A plus n minus 1 into D. Then the reciprocal of A is 1 by A, which is the first term of harmonic progression. Similarly, the reciprocal of A plus n minus 1 into D, which is the nth term, is of 1 by A plus n minus 1 into D. So this will be the nth term of the harmonic progression. So we are going to deal with this topic in an advanced level. So now we are going to write the genform or the general form of an arithmetic progression. The genform, or in other words called the general form of an arithmetic progression, denoted by means of, or in abbreviation, so it can be written as, so your AP is, so here A, which is the first term, the second term is given by means of A plus D, third term, so here A plus 2D, 1 less than the third, that is 3 minus 1 is of 2D, so here fourth term T4, so here 4 minus 1 is of 3, that is 3D, so overall the third term will be of A plus 3D, and the fourth term, so the A plus 3D, fifth term will be of A plus 5 minus 1 is of 4D, and similarly and so on. So in order to get the nth term, 1 less, that is N minus 1 into D, so here the nth term will be of A plus n minus 1 into d will be the nth term. So here, so this is the genform of a arithmetic progression in which the first term by means of a, the second term as a plus d, third term, and here similarly fourth term, fifth term by a plus 4d, and this will be n minus 1. So here to get the nth term, that is n minus 1, that is n minus 1 into d, or in other words a plus n minus 1 into d is the nth term. So here from this it is clear that first term that is T1 of AP, that is arithmetic progression, is A. So if the first term is of A, then the reciprocal of first term that is the reciprocal of A will be of 1 by A. So here reciprocal is of 1 by A, then the reciprocal term will be is in harmonic progression. Since the first term of arithmetic progression AP is of A, then the reciprocal, that is 1 by A, will be in harmonic progression, that is HP. So similarly, the nth term of the arithmetic progression is of A plus N minus 1 into D. Similarly, nth term of arithmetic progression is of A plus n minus 1 into D, then the nth term of harmonic progression will be the reciprocal of the nth term of AP. So here nth term of the harmonic progression will be the reciprocal of the nth term of arithmetic progression. So here we wrote the nth term of arithmetic progression as A plus N minus 1 to D, then say therefore the nth term of harmonic progression will be of, since we have to write the reciprocal, therefore the reciprocal of A plus N minus 1 into D will be of 1 divided by A plus N minus 1 into D. So this is the reciprocal of A plus N minus 1 into D, which is the nth term of AP. So this will be the nth term, 1 by A plus N minus 1 into D is the reciprocal of this HP, that is harmonic progression. Now, we can write it as, so here hence, since nth term, so here in mathematically we can write it as Tn, that is the nth term, is equals to 1 divided by a plus n minus 1 into d. Based upon this formula, which is the nth term of harmonic progression, so here let us perform a problem. In a HP, that is harmonic progression, say 1 by 12, comma 1 by 18, comma 1 by 24, comma dash dash, consisting infinite number of terms, find the seventh term, find T7, that is seventh term. Then now, so solution starts now. So in our solution, as per the problem, the sequence, the harmonic progression which is given for us is of 1 by 12, comma 1 by 18, comma 1 by 24, comma dash dash. So it is in harmonic progression. So as per the question, so here this sequence is in harmonic progression. Then now the reciprocal terms of the sequence which is in HP, harmonic progression, will be in arithmetic progression. Since these are in harmonic progressions, then reciprocals will be in arithmetic progression. Then let us write the reciprocals of 1 by 12, 1 by 18 and 1 by 24 and so on. The reciprocal of 1 by 12 is of 12 by 1, which is nothing but 12, comma 1 by 18's reciprocal is of 18 by 1. So 18 by 1 is equals to 18 again. So 18 is the reciprocal of 1 by 18. Similarly, 1 by 24's reciprocal is of 24 and similarly and so on. So this sequence will be in case of the arithmetic progression. So here, let us write the first term, the second term, here third term. So here, as per the condition is here, first term is of 12. So your first term is given by means of A, that is equals to 12. So in this manner, I got, so your A value as 12. Then now, so here since the sequence is in AP, so difference will be common. The difference of the first two consecutive terms and the next two consecutive terms will be equal. So here, let us write the common difference now. So here, common difference is denoted by means of common difference. Diff indicates here difference. So T1 is the first term. Then common difference denoted by D is equals to T2 minus T1. So here, let us find out the common difference, that is D equals to second term T2 is of 18 minus T1, the first term, is of 12. 12 is of negative and 18 is of positive. To simplify further, so here plus of minus is minus. Let us subtract greater minus least. 18 minus 12 is of 6. Then now to assess the sign of this 6, we have to see the greater among these two. 18 is greater than 12. 18 sign is of positive. Therefore, 6 assesses the sign of positive. So in this manner, I got the value of D, that is the common difference, is of 6. Then now, we have to find out, as per the problem, the seventh term of HP. So we have to find out the seventh term, that is T7 or the seventh term. In order to find out that too, you have to find out the seventh term of HP. But first of all, let us write the, so we are in arithmetic progression, since this sequence is of arithmetic progression. Then now, in order to find out the nth term, so there is a formula, that is Tn is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. So we know that, nth term of arithmetic progression is given by means of the formula, that is a plus n minus 1 into d. But here we are going to find out the seventh term. So in order to get the seventh term, that is T7, so n must be replaced by means of 7. So here n is equals to 7, at n is equals to 7, then now a value and as well as d values are of, so here a is of 12 and d is of 6. Then now, so a is of 12 and d is of 6. Then now we are going to replace these values in the formula, that is tn equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. Then that equals to a is of 12 plus n minus 1, n is of 7, so 7 minus 1 into d. So d value is of 6. That implies T7, the seventh term of arithmetic progression, is given by means of 12 plus 7 minus 1 within the bracket is of 6 and into 6 within the bracket. Then now that implies T7, the seventh term, is given by means of 12 plus 6, 6 is of 36, 6 6 is of 36. Then now the further logical step will be of, that implies T7, the seventh term, equals to 12 plus 36, 6 plus 2 is of 8, 3 plus 1 is of 4. Then now, so here hence, therefore, this is the seventh term. So here seventh term of arithmetic progression is 48. Then reciprocal term of the seventh term is equals to, so here 48 is the seventh term of AP, then the reciprocal of this 48 will be of 1 by 48. So here hence, since it is the reciprocal, this is the reciprocal term, then reciprocal term will be definitely in case of harmonic progression. Hence the seventh term of harmonic progression is equals to 1 by 48.